Hey everyone, and welcome to the real life part of this video, episode 5. And as you might have guessed in the time lapse that we just did, we started on a new area in the park. The area is called Pine Valley, and it's the newest addition to the park so far. Of course, it's the first themed area, so it's not really a new addition or anything. It's just a new area, but it's a fun one, and I'm really looking forward to how it's going to turn out. And so far, I'm very pleased with the results. So we did just a small time lapse before this commentary, and I just showed you the rope course, which we're going to look closer to in a second. But I did much more, and if you followed me on Twitter the past weeks, I did a lot of stuff off camera. I did a lot of groundwork and planning, and I also started working on two restaurants, or one restaurant and one takeaway thingy. And also, of course, we're going to look at it, but it was mostly planning and getting the style and the theme right. So we're going to take a look at all of that, but first off, I want to show you the overview of the area. Everything you see right now, and especially the pathwork and everything, is what we are going to do in this area, or what it will be in this area. It's a rather small area, so to say, but it's pretty big in terms of what I've done so far in the game, and I'm really excited for it, and so far it looks pretty cool. So as you can see, it connects nicely to the main street. It's just a small little walk, but you could come in here with the view of the rapid at first. But it also connects, as I explained, I think, to the main park over here, which I also started working on a little bit, but we are going to talk about that maybe in a future episode or something, when we actually work on a park. Anyway, when you enter the area over here, you have either the option to go to another themed land and walk around the park, or go to the themed land. And the first ride you will probably notice from a distance is the Wild Aces, right? I think, or I called it Wild Ace. I'm not really sure what it's called in game. White, blue, or something blue. I don't know. It's a fun little ride, and I think it would fit nicely in the area, even though it's a little bit big compared to the style I'm going for. Especially when you're looking from the main street, it might be a little bit bigger. So it's noticeable, and it's nice, I guess. But the second ride you might notice, or even notice at first, is the Rapids River ride. This is pretty much inspired by the Grizzly River Run in Disney California Adventure. Again, very big inspiration for this area, and you will notice that with the rope course we did a second ago as well. But it's a fun little addition with some drops and twisty turns, and it's just a fun rapids, and I'm very pleased with it. In the next episode, we are going to work on it some more. And as you can see, I already laid out some of the queue work and even some theming around it. But next episode, we are going to dive in that way more. But it's just something I wanted to show you in advance. So that's those two functioning rides are in this area. So we've got the Wild Aces aeroplane, I don't know, and the Rapids River. Then we also have some shops over here and over here as well. And then before we go to the rope course, I wanted to show you the restaurant for this area. It's the Fowler's Inn. It's a grill house, and you can all sorts of get some all sorts of meat and stuff like that, and sodas and burgers and I don't know, beef, steaks, I don't know. It's just a grill house, and you get lots of it. And I think some of you might have expected this already from me, that I tried some interiors, and also I posted a teaser from this. It's just a small interior, and especially the counter is very inspired by the work of Lone Wolf and CTR Synth in their Xoo project, if I'm pronouncing that correct. They did it for the Shy Guys World summer competition, and I think they gave something new, a new twist on how we could do interiors, or at least restaurants, and I thought it wouldn't be nice, so I tried my hand at it. And even though it looked very copied, I did try my hand at making it a little bit more original, or my own, that is. And I think I succeeded nicely in that. As you can see, there are still some chairs and interior pieces missing, so we might go in and add them when the anniversary update is coming, because there will be some picnic benches and I don't know what sort or what themed or how they even look, besides the one we got to see in the Frontier Expo. But maybe they will fit in the interior, or I will need to make them my own. We'll see how that goes. But it's just that's basically the Fowler Inn. And we've got two little eating areas around it. They are raised above the ground, so it's just a nice little seating area. With especially on this side, you have a nice view on the drop of the Rapids River, the big drop, and the little area I can get really close to. So that's basically the Fowler Inn. And then I extended the path over here a little bit, and the idea that I have is that there will be an hotel over here themed in the same style as this area. So there will be an hotel over here with, of course, its own parking lot and well, the hotel itself, and it will connect over here to this side of the park. And then over here we will have an expansion of the parking lot. I'm not sure if this is going to be dirt or grass or just asphalt as we have over here, but it will be an extension. So you'll probably do all of that off camera. Maybe I will record something of the hotel. I'm not really sure. I'm not even sure when I'm going to build it. So yeah, we'll see when it comes, and I'll be sure to cover it. But that's basically this side of the area. And then we have two more things in this area to show. Something we completed in the time lapse, of course, the rope course, which is inspired by the rope course in California Adventure, once again. I think it's called the Redwood Challenge Parkour or something like that. It's a fun little thing, and of course that's mostly just rope bridges and stuff like that, and I really made it a rope course. But it's just a fun little addition, and I thought it would be fun to look at that and try my hand on it. You will notice that it's pretty standard in terms of what rope courses look like or can look like. It's just some obstacles and different things, and the safety barrel or a thing above the obstacles to keep you attached to the rope you're hanging on, and so you don't fall to your death or anything. Or well, it's not that high, of course, but well, it is on this side, but anyway. So that's the idea. Of course, it's not functioning, it's just being here to look good and well, add a little thing to the area, which I think it does. So in these towers over here, which are covered with a roof, we have in this side we have the first aid and the toilet. Of course, this now serves as only the toilet building, but there is a first aid as well. And then on this side we have a gift shop. So I might do an interior for this, I'm not really sure. I think I will do, but it's just a little fun addition to it. And then of course the rope bridge over here, and then a little playground net over here with two slides. I thought this was a neat idea, and I think, as I said, this is a bit inspired by the rope course in California Adventure, and they have these slides which are themed to a tree trunk. So I thought it would be nice to try that out. And I actually had an animatronic hover above it when I first tried it out. And they actually a peep fits into this tube. So that's a nice little touch, and it's just a little something. Then right next to that we've got some stepping stones over the small river we've got in this area. And you can go from this side to the other side, or go by bridge or anything. It's just a nice little touch, and I added these nets so when you fall into the water you don't go into the entire river or anything, if everything goes well and you're not an asshole who basically jumps the rope. Anyway, there will always be some people, staff members, walking around in the area to keep sure everyone is safe, and especially with the rope course there will be more employees taking care that everything is going all right. So as I said, we have this little river and it connects a little bit to the rapids ride, and the station is going to be over here. So it connects a little bit, and then basically that would be like an extension of the rapids or the river itself, which you could surf or something. And these bridges basically connect it with the restaurant and the entrance of the rapids, right? And then over here we've got another little restaurant and of course the entrance to the Wild Aces, right? I will theme this towards like an airfield hangar, where you can, which would be over here or something. I don't really know. It's pretty basic and it's not that original because the Brocosters guys did it, and I think Tomes on Shaggy's World did this as well. But I think it would be a nice touch, and I'm going to try and make it a bit more original, or at least to fit it with the style of this tower. So that's going to be nice. And then over here we are going to have a small little open air theater. This is just a placeholder. This is taken from the Brocosters guys again. Sorry, but I'm going to make this more original, and especially the stage and area will be a little bit themed. I don't think I'm going to make it like a cowboy and Indian thing. That would be way too standard, but it's something like, I don't know, Grizzly thing, or maybe some fur markets, which would be like the type area or time period this area would be in. I don't really know what's going on over there, but it's going to be themed towards some time period, and there will be a play over there every now and then in the park. So that's basically it for this area. Next episode, we are going to work, as I said, on this station and the queue of the rapids, and maybe do some work on the rapids itself. What you might expect, I said before that this is going to be, or the layout is inspired by the Grizzly River Run in California Adventure. That doesn't mean that there is going to be a direct copy of, or the recreation of it. I will not do that. This is just going to be themed like an mountain or something, and lumberjack mountain or something like that. And so there won't be a giant grizzly head on top of the mountain, or carved out of the mountain, I don't know, because as you can see, the top part of this is as high as the top of the theater. So if imagine that there would be a gigantic head over here, that would look insane. So I'm not going to do that, and don't worry about it. It's just going to be a nice little mountain over here, which we are going to work on in maybe the next episode, maybe some future episode. I'm not really sure. I don't have a schedule just yet. Anyway, that's basically it for this episode. I know it was a bit of a shorter one in terms of what we actually built, but that's because all the work I did off camera, especially the planning and the restaurant itself, took a lot of time, and I just wanted to show what we are going to do with this area. So as I said, it's going to be like a smaller type of area in the park, but definitely a fun one, and as I said, I'm very happy with the style I'm going for, and how it looks so far. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so yeah, that's basically it for now. As I said millions of times by now, I think, but yeah, that's it. Okay, I'm going to close this off, and I want to thank you all for watching so far. If you've liked it, if you have any suggestions for maybe even some more rides over here in this area, let me know down in the comments below, and or if you just want to say hi or anything, let me know. I appreciate it a lot. Anyway, thanks for watching once again, and I really hope to see you next time. Bye bye.